this week-ish.
Come on, come on.
Just been with Nikki out there.
Yeah, how
we... Whew, what a week, what a weekend. You ready for it?
Yeah.
OK, let's see what happened this week in history, apart from the fact that Humphrey B. Bear is celebrating 50 years, so happy birthday.
Really?
Humphrey B. Bear. He's 50.
And he still can't speak.
And he's still got no pants. But anyway, in 1889, the brassiere was invented. The brassiere was invented, or as I used to call it at primary school, the over-the-shoulder boulder holder. It was invented by Christine Hutz, who patented the first model there of the bra that you can see in 1889. And even today, I still have no back fat, officially. So the brassiere, I guess, as someone who doesn't traditionally wear a bra, I guess they have changed the world. The famous evolution of women from Patti Page to Marilyn Monroe and Madonna.
That's a pointy bra.
Oh, yes, that's very pointy. Look at this.
This is the first. So beautiful.
First woman who made the bra look very, very interesting.
There's Madonna.
Sorry, I'm just transfixed by the brassiere acting. Is that Madonna?
Yeah,
I think it is. And Jane Russell also starred in a bra commercial for the bustier woman in the 70s. Here, have a look at this.
Well, I wear the 18-hour long line.
Hubba, hubba.
This special 18-hour fabric stretches every way you do.
18 hours.
Supports comfortably. And look how smooth.
Look at that.
If real support and real comfort are what you look for, look for the 18-hour long line.
That's an early advertorial, I understand.
It's not the Paris bra. Why wear a bra for 18 hours?
Well, some people have to for their life, you know, their work. Some female impersonators, of course, wear the bra. Oh, hello, is this going on the air? Of course, you would remember Jane Russell as someone of my own age there.
Absolutely. Yes.
Changed our lives, those bras.
Why when obviously everyone thought that Jono was going to say, you remember wearing a bra, did the camera go to me?
But it briefly flicked to me first, so I had a moment of terror.
I know. Now, a moment of terror, we're about to get it all over again, but on this this week in 1977, one of Joe's favourite movies and my favourite movies opened in Hollywood.
Yeah.
Star Wars! Look at that. That music. John Williams' music. 1977. I remember seeing this at the Hoyts Entertainment Centre. Absolutely fantastic. Look at that. Star Wars. And I brought in to show the young people watching, which... this is the Star Wars, those sound effects and albums.
Oh my God.
It earned $461 million in the United States and $314 million overseas, totaling $775 million, not to mention video rights, DVDs and stuff, and all the poster art and all the stuff, that collectible stuff that people have collected over the years. This is the Star Wars album that I brought in. This is a picture disc, which I bought for $9.99, but they actually, they're all coming out again. That's a vinyl record with sound effects and the music and stuff from Star Wars. And that's Devo's version as well. So, anyway, all that stuff's available. Also, in this week, in 1969, one of my heroes, John Lennon and Yoko Ono, recorded Give Peace a Chance. They did it, I think, in a couple of places, Amsterdam Hilton, and I think they also did it in Canada, in Vancouver. This is the video that they did for Give Peace a Chance. And myself and Dano on the radio, we did a special tribute. That's us. I'm Yoko. And... I'm not wearing a bra because I don't think Yoko wore a bra. But that was a promotion for Put Some Pork on Your Fork. That was Give Schnitz a Chance. Bring back your schnitzel. Wasn't that great, Yoko?
You look rather fetching on us, sir.
Let's talk later, Don. Also today, having birthdays apart from Humphrey B. Bear, Mel B, one of the Spice Girls. Mel B is 40 today. Scary Spice! Ask all her ex-husbands. She's definitely Scary Spice. Mel B, 40. And, of course, our own Tash Belling, 40 today. 40 years young. And my little friend, Kylie Minogue, is 47 today. That was taken at Channel 7, Saturday Morning Live. And that's the birthday girl herself. So happy birthday if you're having one. You're sharing it with all those people. That's basically some of the things that happened this week in history. And the rest, as they say, Sarah, is history.
Fantastic. Thank you, Jono.